Imagine you're a cow, or a deer, or a giraffe. What does that make you? An even-toed ungulate. These are animals whose hooves are split to form two toes. Now that all sounds fine, until you find out that whales are also even-toed ungulates, despite the fact that they have no toes. That's because whales actually evolved from land mammals that were closely related to hippopotamuses around 50 million years ago. So what happened to whales' toes? Well, as they adapted to swimming in water, they grew fins and they became streamlined, and as their legs retracted into their bodies, so too did the toes on the ends of those legs. Now, under this umbrella of water-dwelling mammals that evolved from hippopotamuses, known as cetaceans, you might recognize this animal. A killer whale, right? But why do we call it that? If you look at this tree, known as a phylogeny, it's not even in the same family as any of the other so-called whales. In fact, it's in the Delphinidae family, meaning a killer whale is nothing more than a species of dolphin. And if that makes you cross, then listen to this. I'm about to prove to you that all dolphins are whales. There's 100% no doubt that a sperm whale is a whale, and a blue whale is also a whale, definitely. So you'd be right in thinking that they're related and part of the same group. Well, yeah, but a sperm whale is actually far more closely related to dolphins than they are to blue whales. So if a sperm whale is a whale, and a blue whale is a whale, and even a killer whale is a whale, even though it's literally a dolphin, then all dolphins are whales.